know the difference between starving and fasting. One can starve, one can fast, but not starve. So that way cleans up the body. And the mind also functions in a clean body, so it's happy to function in a well-cleaned instrument. But when you lose the body, you still have your desires. You have to fulfill the desires. So you are given another body. That's what you call reincarnation. Whether you believe it in reincarnation or not, you should know that you don't die and your mind seldom dies. The mind is still there. The mind needs a body to fulfill its desires. In fact, even this body you got because of your desires. Such desires that can be fulfilled only through a human body. You got the human body. If your desires are different, you sure get a different body. So according to our desires, we create our body. Even in this body itself, if your desires are always good and yogic, your body changes. After a while, people can look at your face. You seem to be so peaceful, you're happy. So happy. Are you practicing yoga? They may ask you, because it's expressed in the face. Your whole body gets transformed to be a yogic body because of your desires in the mind. The same way, if your desires are wrong, even though you look pretty and beautiful, people say, look, it's a crook going there. Why? It's expressed in the face. Every thought makes a change in the body. When somebody looks at you and say, oh, you seem to be so happy today. What's happening? What do they see? Your happiness, your face. Why? Your happy thought makes a happy face. Your angry thought makes an angry face. Your sad thought makes a sad face. But the change is not only in the face. It changes the whole body. It's the face that we see mostly. But that doesn't mean the whole body is not changed. So be careful about your thoughts. As you think, so you become.